This video is on reactive oxygen species we call ROS, oxidative damage and antioxidant system in plants. ROS are highly reactive chemical molecules formed due to electron acceptability of oxygen. So this diagram shows the ultimate product of oxygen, such as electron transport chain formed in water. But if the oxygen molecules is less loaded by electrons before going into forming of water, so it can produce these reactive oxygen molecules. So in the first step, when it accepts just one electron, it produces superoxide. Then if it is loaded by another, it forms hydrogen peroxides. And if it is loaded by another electron, it forms hydroxy radicals. So this is how reactive oxygen species are formed in the cell. From the basic chemistry knowledge, so this oxygen contains 8 electrons. So focus on this shelf, the outermost one. So it contains 2, 4, 6 electrons. But when we come to reactive oxygen species, this oxygen atom has unpaired electron. That's how it's become very unstable. So you can see it has only 2, 4, 5 electrons and one is missing. So sometimes we call these free radicals because these are very reactive species. But all ROS are not free radicals, because there are two categories of ROS: radicals or non-radicals. So superoxide, hydroxyl, peroxyl, alkyloxyl, hydroxyperoxyl are radicals. Non-radicals are H2O2 or hydrogen peroxide, hypochlorous acid, ozone, singlet oxygen, peroxynitrite. And when we come to sources of reactive oxygen species, it can be either endogenous or exogenous. Endogenous means it produced within the plant cell. So chloroplast, peroxisome, and mitochondria are the major organelles that produce ROS in a plant cell, and also it produces in the plasma membrane. Apart from that, there are some amount of ROS being produced in glycosome, ER, or endoplasmic reticulum, and sometimes also in the cytosol. So in each pathway that organelles is responsible for is producing some amount of ROS. For instance, during chloroplast, in the chloroplast, during photosynthesis, it produces some amount of ROS. And also in the peroxisome, during glycosylate cycle, it produces some ROS. And in the mitochondria, from the electron transport chain, it produces ROS. So and on the other hand, there are some ROS produced exogenously. That means due to some effect by abiotic or biotic stresses. Abiotic means such, the environmental conditions, harsh ones, such as heat, cold, salinity, water deficiency, and so on. Biotic means it is by insects, pathogens, and so on. And the cell possess reactive oxygen species scavenging system, because these molecules are very harmful for cell, so they scavenge very rapidly. So it has two systems. First one is antioxidant enzymes. It can be either superoxide dismutase that reduce superoxide radicals into H2O2, and catalase, it reduces this H2O2 into O2 and H2O. And ascorbate peroxidase, it is having the same functions such as in catalase, that reduce H2O to H2O and dehydroascorbate. And monodehydroascorbate reductase, dehydroascorbate reductase, glutathione peroxidase, and guaiacol peroxidase. These four enzymes, all together with ascorbate peroxidase, are involved in ascorbate glutathione cycle that reduce H2O2 to water. And these are the subcellular localization of these enzymes. And The second category is non-enzymatic antioxidants such as ascorbic acid, reduced glutathione, tocopherol, carotenoids, flavonoids, sometimes phenols, and proline. Proline is an amino acid. This is also involved in reducing reactive oxygen species. And normally, cells have reactive oxygen species and antioxidant system in a balanced level. But if it is under stress condition or some harsh condition, there is an imbalance between antioxidant system and ROS. That means high levels of ROS are produced in the cell that can't be scavenged by the antioxidant system. That's how oxidative stress is developed in the cell. This high level of ROS is harmful for cells because it damages and make some consequences in plants or any other tissues. So they damage major macromolecules such as lipids, proteins, DNA, and also carbohydrates. For instance, lipid peroxidation is one of them. It reacts with membrane lipids, in the cell membrane. And finally, they produce methylaldehyde, acrolein, like molecules, and also it damage proteins directly, modifications or indirect modifications. And these damages can be reversible or irreversible. Irreversible modifications are very harmful for cell because it can't be reversed. And damaging DNA, it can oxidize deoxyribose sugars and also make some changes or modifications in nucleotide bases and also break DNA strand and also make some crosslinks in the DNA and make some mutations. And in carbohydrates, it modify the metabolic enzymes and also inhibit glycolysis and TCA cycle enzymes and also reduce carbon fixation. So all these things related to ROS damage is involved in cell death and also reducing growth and yield loss in plants. And this is all for this video, and thank you.